Hello and welcome to a very special edition of One Cool Thing, which is special this time because we actually have two cool things to share with you. They are both chips. One is from AMD and the other one is from Nvidia. I'm Tom Brant. This is Matt Buzzi, and he is here to tell us all about the latest Nvidia GeForce RTX graphics chips for gaming laptops.
Yes, the long anticipated arrival of the RTX 30 series on laptops. They were a smash hit on desktop, both for their performance and their value. There's no, you know, beating around the bush. They cost less and give better performance than the 20 series generation on desktop. And so why wouldn't everybody want that in their laptops? They are not a totally mixed bag, but they're not as much of a smash hit on laptops, I guess, would be my big overview. They definitely do offer increased performance over the 20 series, but there's a lot of caveats and some interesting things we found in our testing. More variation between the chips, even the same GPU, comes in kind of a wider range of performance. So there's a lot of reasons for that. We can get into it. One of the first things I reviewed with one of these new GPUs is the Alienware M15, and that's one of our favorite gaming laptops in general, but this one had the RTX 3070, and compared to the other 3070 GPUs we got in, it was the best performer. It was the full power version of the chip, not a lower wattage version. So it really kind of 15 frames per second improved over the previous generation RTX 20 series, which is definitely good for gamers. Importantly, it's also better at ray tracing. It's also better at 4K. So 1080p performance is a modest improvement, but when you're looking to scale up towards those enthusiast levels, better at 4K, better at ray tracing, that's kind of where those really hardcore gamers are looking to like push the margins of their performance. So definitely something to be excited about. If you have a newer 20 series GPU, I don't know if it's essential that you run out and replace your laptop right away. Unfortunately, unlike desktops, you have to replace the whole system. So it's a pretty expensive endeavor just to upgrade to these new GPUs if you already have a recent one.
But as you mentioned, specifically with that Alienware, it's actually not a crazy expensive type machine, right? It's less than $2,000.
It's right about there. $2,100. You can go up to $2,500 as tested. So in our review configuration, so that's you know, with more storage, with a 4K screen, you can get it more, you know, closer to $2,000. So if you want the 1080p high refresh rate screen, which I would recommend over the 4K display that we tested, because for gaming, I don't know, even though these chips are better at 4K, it's something where you're going to be diminishing your headroom, and then in a game that isn't as graphic intensive, it's a competitive multiplayer game, you can't even benefit from the higher frame rates on your screen because you can't see them because it's limited to 60 hertz. So I would go for the higher refresh screen personally, less expensive and in my opinion better for gaming. That said, the 4K OLED screen doesn't look really good, so pros and cons. But yeah, it's right around that $2,000 range, and it's a really nice laptop still. The only thing they changed in that version was the GPU itself, which it's better. It's better. It's not a world of difference as we saw on desktop. And I know that you got a different kind of experience, a different way to test these new GPUs, very different than this 15-inch gaming laptop that I got.
Right. So at the other end of the spectrum, we have one of the most unique applications of the new RTX graphics chips, which is from Asus in the form of an ultra portable gaming laptop, which is similar to like a Dell XPS 13 or Razer Blade Stealth, but that connects to an external graphics card, an eGPU, that is actually that is actually an RTX 3080 laptop graphics chip. But we found, and I have it right here, this is the Asus ROG XG Mobile with the RTX 3080 in it. But as you were saying that there's so much variation in these new chips' performance, we actually found that the Alienware with an RTX 3070 performs better than this eGPU with an RTX 3080. So the moral of the story with these new chips is, yes, they're capable. Yes, you can find some good deals with the new laptops, but not all of them are created equal.
Yeah, we have had plenty of experience with these eGPUs in the past. It's usually a bit of a headache. They don't offer the same performance as the pure chip on its own, and kind of transferring over, usually Thunderbolt diminishes the performance. But this Asus solution has its own proprietary connection Was the performance better than what we saw out of the Thunderbolt? Was it closer to the other?
Well, so let's just say that with this XG Mobile eGPU, you can more than double the performance of the graphics in the laptop itself, which is, you know, a GTX graphics card. But that still doesn't mean that it's going to be the same as the performance if you had that RTX 3080 in the laptop. So it seems like, to sum up that whole RTX launch, is pay attention to the specs. And, you know, of all the things we've tested, we've only tested three or four, including the CGPU. The Alienware is probably your best bet.
Yeah, so far the best performance implementation we've seen of the new GPUs. I have a whole piece on PCMag about the differences and why this is sort of the dynamic that's emerging. We tested three different RTX 3070s and saw, especially in one laptop that was way below the Alienware's performance, even though it theoretically had the same GPU, it has a lot to do with the wattage, how the manufacturer implements it. And so you can unfortunately get an RTX 3070 that performs more like a 3060, or even a lower wattage 3080 that performs more like a 3060. So you really got to be careful. Nvidia said it's working on kind of its messaging and branding about making it more clear which kind of GPU it is, because right now the manufacturers are not required to tell you what kind it is, whether it's max Q, whether it's a lower wattage version by default. So they just can list 3070, and that can mean a lot of different things. So check out that piece for some of the differences, and definitely dive into the specs. I know everyone doesn't know necessarily what all of the TDP and the wattage and all of that means when they glance at a laptop, but do try to look as closely as you can when buying one of these GPUs, and read our reviews, because that's why we test these things. That's the importance of our lab-based testing. So yeah. GPUs were not the only thing that was new recently, though. We got new processors. AMD's been killing it lately in the processor game, and they had yet another launch recently. Busy time in components. Tell me more about AMD's latest Ryzen chips.
Right. So basically what AMD has done is they've moved to a Zen 3, what they're calling a Zen 3 method of producing laptop and desktop processors. These are not the graphics processors we were just talking about, but the CPU that is the main processor. And so this Zen 3, these Zen 3 chips are the Ryzen 5000 series, which are starting to show up in some laptops now, but really won't start rolling out until next month, which granted is next week, but that's when we're going to start to see them. As is typical for a new CPU generation, there's some slight performance increases. We're not talking about a huge leap. And if you already have a Ryzen powered laptop, you're probably not going to want to upgrade. But if you've got an Intel powered gaming laptop or something like that from a few years ago, the Ryzen 5000, especially the Ryzen 9 5000 series, is an amazing chip for people who want decent gaming performance, but also the best multi-core performance for things like video editing, rendering images. That's where it really shines.
Sure. Yeah, we used to have a situation only 2 or 3 years ago where AMD processors were the kind of value play, and that was really the main draw. And now we're in a situation very quickly where they are both often a better value and definitely a better performer. These Ryzen 9 chips especially, including in gaming laptops, including in non-gaming laptops, are really, really impressive. They're good at kind of, as you said, kind of everything, media editing, gaming. And gaming was kind of the last holdout that that Intel was holding an edge, and AMD is now closing that gap too. So more options are good, hopefully more competitive prices. There's some really nicely priced laptops right now that offer quite good performance for their dollar. So yeah, this is a pretty good time to be buying a laptop, honestly.
Yeah, and it's also a time when more people need laptops that have those powerful processors, because you're probably using the same machine to do your work and then maybe play games in the after work period, because you're not going anywhere for many, many people who are stuck at home for both work and entertainment. So be sure to check out our reviews. We mentioned the Alienware M15 R4, I believe, is that correct? Alienware M15 R4, which is our new top choice for gaming laptops. And then we also have a review of the Asus ROG Flow X13, which has that new Ryzen 5000 chip in it. check out those reviews. Check out more at PCMag.com for everything you need to know about buying a laptop in 2021. It's an exciting time, as you mentioned, and we hope to bring more reviews and cool things to you in the near future.